But I will only focus on the set of these equations, the free space equations, and I will say that when electromagnetic waves following these equation just hits this boundary. Now this boundary is actually shared between the free space and the medium. So this is for them together, only the boundary. So we will have to apply boundary conditions, and based on these equations, we can derive the boundary conditions. Now how the boundary conditions are derived, we will cover this when we will cover the BS electrodynamics. We will derive the boundary conditions from these equations, but at the moment I will write them directly, but will explain a little bit. I will just impose two conditions, that when we will have no free charge and current, when there will be no free charge and when there will be no free current, then this rho f will be equal to 0, this jf will be equal to 0, and our boundary conditions will become like, we will resolve the electric field into two components, like the parallel component and the perpendicular component, and we will resolve the magnetic field in parallel and perpendicular components. Now here, when we will be explaining this one, we will only consider the electric field, because only with the consideration of electric field, the magnetic field is always perpendicular to it. So when we consider only electric field, we can resolve this problem, that why this line is bending. So the conditions are that the dielectric constant epsilon 1 is actually the, so let me write this as epsilon I. This is the incident medium, epsilon I, and the electric field I, which is perpendicular, is equal to the dielectric constant of the transmission medium, and the electric field of transmission medium and perpendicular component, while the parallel components of the electric field, which is the EI parallel, is equal to ET parallel. So the parallel components will remain the same, while the perpendicular components are affected by the dielectric constant of the two media. Now how this equation is derived? This equation is actually derived by considering the Maxwell equations in a medium and applying that there is no free charge and there is no free current. So we can derive the boundary condition, the first one, from here. And similarly, we can write for the magnetic field that they are actually the perpendicular to each other. So the parallel component of electric field is the same. In magnetic field, the perpendicular component of the magnetic field will remain the same, and that will be that the magnetic field perpendicular component is equal to the magnetic field transmitted perpendicular component. So these two will remain the same, while the parallel component will be, is here we are having mu here for the medium. So 1 over mu 1, which is mu I, and b I, and this is now the parallel component, is equal to 1 over mu t and b t and perpendicular, parallel component. So, the parallel component of the magnetic field will now be depending on the permeability of the medium. So, we are having these boundary conditions. Now, with the help of these boundary conditions, we will have to understand that why this light bends actually. Now to understand this dielectric constant, that what this dielectric constant is, we will have to think of this from the wave equation. As we know that the Maxwell equations are actually coupled equations. Here the electric field, so here we are having the magnetic field. Here the magnetic field, we are having the electric field here. So they are coupled equations, and when we would like to uncouple them, we can utilize all these equations and we can uncouple them. And the uncoupling will cost us from the first order differential equation, we will go to the second order differential equation. So the second order differential equation will be the del square E will be equal to 1 over del square E is mu naught epsilon naught and curly square E over curly T square. Similarly, del square B will be equal to mu naught epsilon naught and curly square B over curly T squared. Now, if I look to the wave equation, then the wave equation is that del square of any function f is equal to 1 over v square, v being the velocity, and curly square f over curly t squared. So from here I can write that the velocity of electromagnetic wave is actually 1 over mu naught c, 1 over mu naught epsilon naught, and this I define is the speed of light, the velocity of electromagnetic waves. Now I can write that this V is now defined as this. So the V I will actually define by that inside a medium it will be mu and epsilon and square root. So this thing I can further say that this will be C over N, where N being the refractive index is the ratio of the speed of light in a medium to the speed of light in vacuum. So I can further write this thing that for N it will be C over V, and C is 1 over mu naught epsilon naught. So I can write 1 over mu naught epsilon naught, and V is mu and epsilon, so 1 over, so it will go up and it will become epsilon mu and square root will come in. Now we know that for most of the media mu is approximately equals to mu naught. So, the only left term we are having is epsilon over epsilon naught and square root. And this we define is the refractive index, or we call the dielectric constant, epsilon, or the relative permittivity, or we call it a dielectric constant, and the square root of this is actually the refractive index. So we will focus on the dielectric constant. Now when I consider here, then this is the medium which will have the dielectric constant is this, and this medium will have its dielectric constant is this. Now, I know here that the dielectric constant of the dense medium is actually greater than the rare medium. So what the dielectric constant actually does, dielectric constant of a dielectric material is actually that gives you the degree of electric polarization of that material. Then how quickly that material can be polarized means how much it can withstand. The dielectric constant will tell you how much electric field how much a material withstands a given external electric field.